So let me show you the project for us completed. Isn't that beautiful? I love that. It's all paper and glue. And it's pretty easy to do. I even show you how to put this together in a clean, neat, and simple way. So to make this project, you don't need a whole lot of supplies. I'm a straight edge, maybe a couple of straight edges. So tacky glue is really recommended. It helps a lot with this project, but you can do without it. White glue will be all right. Glue sticks. I use a bone folder, which I love. Something to cut with can be either an X-Acto knife or a pair of scissors, you know, to cut out the various pieces. But yeah, you can improvise a lot of this stuff. The tacky glue, though, is nice to have. You'll see. Okay, and I print this up on cardstock, which is a little bit thicker than regular paper. You don't have to, but you can buy cardstock for $5 at Walmart. I'll put a link in the description of this video if you want to buy some cardstock. It's thinner than manila file folder. And if you need to improvise, then you can draw this out on manila file folders if you have some. So print up the template. The link is in the description of this video. There's the inner box. Four pieces make up the outer box, and then the struts and the spacers. So go ahead and let's start with the inner box. Cut out that the box, and I recommend you cut out the inner squares first. That makes it a little bit easier to work with. And in this template, solid lines are cut lines, dashed lines are fold lines. So don't cut any dashed lines. Just cut the solid lines. But there we go. There's our inner box. And this is a cute little 2-inch square cube. And then go ahead and fold it. And see how the bone folder is nice? And if you use a straight edge when folding, it really makes a difference. And use something else other than a bone folder if you don't have one. So now, in the template, I made a little bit of a extraneous piece here. These two tabs on the short, and see that? Left and right there. These two tabs are unnecessary, so you can go ahead and cut those off. I haven't redone the template. I mean, you could keep them, but a little bit neater without them. So let's glue it together. Glue the four like this to make the almost cube. And see how glue stick is nice for this. And then, you know, fold those tabs down. And then go ahead and glue the final two squares on. Easy enough. 3 minutes in, we've made ourselves a 2-inch cube. See, there's another thing about the bone folder I like. So you can reach in there and, you know, get at the glue. And that's it. 2-inch square. Nice. I like it. So now we move on and make the large square cube. Excuse me. The large cube. There are four parts. Two there. One there. And one there. And this is a 5-inch cube. So just like we did with the smaller cube, go ahead and cut out the inner squares first. See, my finger almost slipped there at that knife. You gotta watch my thumb. Gotta be careful there when you're cutting. Like, you see my thumb on my right hand? Yeah, you always gotta watch that. If your knife, this is why you don't use a plastic ruler. Plastic rulers, your X-Acto will get caught. I like to use a metal straight edge. So cut those pieces all out. And the little notches. It's all very self-evident. One more notch to go there. But now use a bone folder to fold down all the dashed lines. Cut out these squares here. Well, let me know what you think about this camera angle. I don't use this camera angle very often. Straight overhead camera view. Let me know if you think you find it awkward or if you find it comfortable. I've done 1,000 videos with the other camera angle, so this one for me is a little bit awkward. So let's glue those two sections together. This will give us the shape of our cube. got another project too. I got a pyramid shape that I like. I had it in a previous video. I should do a tutorial on that one. Let me know if you want me to do a tutorial on that one. Thanks for watching this video. Thanks for hanging in there so long. Hit that subscribe button. Give me a thumbs up. Leave a comment. I'm fighting the YouTube algorithm. It's tough, but finish that off by gluing on those squares. Could use your help. Consider supporting me on Patreon. Spread this video around on social media. So let's finish that square, that 5-inch cube. I keep calling it a square. I keep taking this 3-dimensional object and making it a 2-dimensional object. I call a cube a square. So before you know it, I'll be calling the Tesseract a cube. All right, so now this is a little bit of a clever little idea I have here to get that cube mounted in the middle, the small cube inside the big cube. We're going to need spacers. That'll make it really easy. So cut out those spacers, all in the template. And don't forget to cut those lines right there. One in each. And then put them together like this to make an X. Nice. You're going to end up with two of them. I'm thinking about doing a couple more swords. I haven't done swords in a long time. Cardboard or foam board swords. If you get an idea for a cardboard or foam board sword, leave me a comment. I'm thinking Dragon's Dogma. So there you go. Put the spacer inside the box, inside the cube, like this. Side to side, not corner to corner. It's important, you'll see why. Then put your smaller cube in. Put another spacer in there, and it should hold it snug. I measured it all out to hold it snug. Trim your spacers if need be, depending on how well you built your cube. Now you get that cube is suspended in the middle of the cube. Get it as centered as possible, left and right, forward and back. Get it nice and centered, and then we can mount in those struts. I call them struts. And that will finish off this Tesseract. But see, now we can take those out. Once the Tesseract dries, we can take those spacers out. So go ahead and cut out the struts. And notice how there's dashed lines in the center. There's 8 struts. And as always, we fold on the dashed lines. Couldn't get under there with the bone folder, so I used the X-Acto knife to get the fold started. There we go. Start that fold and then bone folder it. Very nice. If you want paper projects, check out my website at stormthecastle.com. I couldn't tell you how many paper projects I have. Paper castles, paper scene boxes, Tarabanco, paper games. I love the simplicity and the creativity of paper. So there you go, the 8 of them. Now, we're going to mount them in to finish off this Tesseract. And see that angled side, the pointed side? That goes in the corner of the big box. And this is how the tacky glue is really helpful. Because it will hold it in place. Now, PVA white glue probably would work fine, but tacky glue is a little bit better because it's got some grip to it. You can put it in there and hold it. Don't have to worry about it falling apart on you. See? Just like that. Adjust that cube as needed to get all 8 of them in there. And I won't show you all 8. I'm just going to do 2 here. Concept is the same. So there we go. I like it. So do all 8 of them, and once those dry, give it time to dry. Once those 8 struts dry, you can take out the spacers, and you have yourself a Tesseract, a 3-dimensional shadow of a 4-dimensional object.